Hi everyone, this is Obi again. I'm back with another video. Today I have something very interesting for you, and it's titled How to Enjoy Your Photos. I mean, the photograph you have, I'm talking specifically the pictures you have on your wall. How to enjoy your photographs. Because a number of us have wedding pictures on our walls. We have pictures maybe from a birthday, special occasions, maybe family pictures. And you've had them on the wall. Some of us don't even know those pictures exist on the wall. Today's video, whether you're a professional man or a layman or an everyday person just like myself, what we are looking at is, okay, these pictures I have on the wall, just like these two landscape pictures I have on the wall, how do I enjoy them? And what do you mean by how to enjoy them? I'm talking about how to view them, how to get more out of them than you are getting right now. So today's video is meant for you and I. Now, if you're a professional person, I'm not going into technical details. Technical details are boring. I just want us to enjoy the pictures we have on our wall. But so let's get into the video proper without wasting much time. But before we get into it proper, you know the drill. If you love this our channel, press the subscribe button. If you enjoy our videos, please press the bell button to know when to be reminded when we post another video, and also share, like, and comment. So with the drill out of the way, I recognize you, all our returning subscribers, and I welcome you, even new subscribers. So with that out of the way, let's get into the video proper. Three reasons informed why I decided to do this video. One of them, I've written these things here, so occasionally you see me looking down so I can make sure I get everything in. One of them is, we had a program last month, that's October, called No Be Ordinary Photo. In that seminar, we looked into the meaning of pictures, part of which I will share here. And what actually prompted me to now want to do this video was that when we were preparing for those for that program, some of the portraits and the pictures I have in the house and some of them in the office, we took them off the wall and took them to the conference grounds. And my wife suddenly remarked to me that the house now looks very bare. And that, yes, really brought to mind the impact of the pictures you have on your wall in your life. You know, we didn't know that place looked bare until we took a good number, not everything, but a good number of them down. The pictures you have on your wall, even if it's 20 years old wedding picture, it's doing something in your life, and that's what we are looking at this evening. Please don't expect the technical details. I'm not going into that. I'm talking about no matter what the picture you have on your wall. Now, that was one reason. So when we took these pictures down, everywhere looked bare, and it came to our realization that yes, these pictures are making impact. Look, people can forget about your sofa, your expensive chairs and cutlery, but they will remember what you have on your wall, because pictures have to do with emotions. So that was one of the reasons. Now, the second reason was because I was listening to somebody, a professional man, talking about museums, and he was saying people should guess how long it takes people who come to the museum to look at a particular portrait or artwork or something. And after some guesses, he now told them that what they have seen is that people use just like 3 seconds to look at the artwork on the wall and move on to the next one. And 3 seconds is not enough to enjoy a portrait or a landscape or a picture. I'm talking of your picture, whatever picture you have on your wall anyway. So this is another reason why you should watch this video to the end. The third reason is I was in the lab, that's the photo lab, to print some of this on my pictures, some of these abstract lines and all the rest. And my friend, the lab manager, asked me, sir, please, I'm sure he's going to watch this video, I'm sure. Sir, please, I normally print these pictures for you, but all these things, talking about stuff like this, what is abstract you bring to print? What actually do they mean? So I explained to him a Yoruba proverb which says, people who buy these kind of things, they have a different way of looking at it. So until you understand the way they look at it, it's just like you may wonder, why do people go sit down listening to a classical jazz pianist play or something? There is a way they listen to it, just like golf too. I mean, if you are somebody whose mindset is active sports, active running up and down, contact and all the rest, and then you come to golf and say, what exactly are they doing, just holding a stick and walking up and down? So watch this video to the end. So my friend, I know you are out there, you're watching this, although we've discussed about it, you understand a little bit more why I come and do this for those who are friends and clients. So without wasting much more time, let me get into a bit. You see, whenever you see pictures like this, Even if it's this, some of these ones I have at the back of the wall, never approach any picture with the ideas you have in your mind. Every picture you see, whether it has an objective where you can point to, oh, this is what this picture is talking about, or it's something like this, you now start thinking, what exactly is the man doing? I don't want to use the word abstract, so we don't go too much technical stuff. Whether it's just lines like this, when you approach it, allow the picture to reveal itself to you. Because if you come with your package, what you think, the box you already have in you, and the ideas you have retained for a long time, what you'll be seeing is, so what are all these lines now? What is it for? But if you still linger a little bit and you look at what is before you, after a while, it begins to unveil. I have some frames on my wall. They speak to me every time, and that's what we are getting into. So a good photograph will always deliver something to you now and in the future to come. Let me give you an example. My prince is not here. It's my... Look at this picture frame. I hope it's straight. You see, you can see lines. All those lines have an origin from here. This is an abstract frame I made with lines talking about destiny and its source. We all arise from one spot, but we are not all going the same direction. Every destiny has its own journey, have its own place. Some discover their destiny early. You can see made a curve and they face their journey. Some, it takes them much time, but at the end of the day, they still fulfill their destiny's goals. Some go this far, maybe to an old age, before they start realizing their destiny. And some continue like that until the day, you know, they get called to heaven and all the rest. So you see, we all have different destiny journeys. So if you are a late starter, don't worry. There is a place for you in life. God has a plan for everybody. So anytime I'm looking at people, analyzing destinies, I stand before this frame and I begin to look. Look, we have separate journeys. Bible says they are not wise comparing themselves one to another. So you have your own journey in life. You have your place in life. You will still fulfill your destiny. Even if you don't discover it early like some of these guys, you are never late to the party, because somewhere along the line, you will still arise, find your way, and still make it. So this is what this frame does for me. So whenever I'm looking at it on the wall, I know the message is bringing. So let's keep this moving. Let me show you another one. Sorry about that. This another one. If you look at this, you may say, so what is all this one? Hey, all this abstract, I don't even know what they are doing. It is... So the proverb I was making the other time was titled, what I said, "Anybody you would have not have," is those who value gold are the ones they sell gold to. This is talking about destiny journeys of each person. If you notice, you see some people start early and begin to rise. Maybe they get to WAEC, they start having problem, they have a little dip and continue to rise again. So if you look at it, each line has a different story to share. There are rises, there are downward spirals, there are upward spirals. So as the life goes on, everybody's destiny continues to unfold. Some, their problems start early. Some, they just like, some of these ones, they start and they just shoot up early, stabilize for a while, rise up again, and then begin to experience some other things. So everybody has his own destiny scroll. This was actually what, if I remember very well, the one my friend in the lab saw and said, "Sir, what's all these abstract something? What do they even do?" It's those who can look at it and understand. And you see these pictures, anytime I stand before them, they will tell me something new. I believe that even as you're looking at it right now, it is saying some things to you. Let's keep it moving because of our time. Let me show you another set of this. This one, I did it to depict the Son of Righteousness that bring healing in his wings. You can see the splash of the sun rays spreads everywhere. So this is what this depicts to me. Keep it moving again because of our time. This particular one, I did it to signify voices. You know, the main voice is a native drum called Gonga in Yoruba language. The main voice is this. This is a talking drum, part of it, but you can begin to understand it. The main voice is this. But you see all these other ones you are seeing, they are also voices too. They add sound to this. But in your life, the major voice in your life should be the voice directing your destiny. I'm a Christian, so the major voice directing my life is the voice of God. Every other voice you are seeing around here, they are also relevant. They add rhythm to this, but follow the main voice, and every other voice are just to aid you. In case they say something different, this is the voice you follow. So this particular picture you are seeing is to depict the voice of God in a man's life. Let's keep it moving. Here I have another one. This one is all about synergy. If you see the way the arches enter, run into one another, is to tell you that no man can go it alone. The beauty of your life and your destiny comes when you are standing in cooperation with other people. If I took only one arch out of this design we are seeing here, it will look so beautiful as it is. But because they are coming together, working in synergy with each other, this picture has relevance. So you can see this is what synergy does. When you work in cooperation with people, no man is an island. We need people. And when we join hands together, we achieve more. Everyone benefits at the end of the day. Let's keep this thing going. The next one we are seeing here is, this is something I did for myself based on the spiritual experience I have, and it's still relevant till now. Now, what you see here is a swirling cloud. This is exactly what I saw. The very first day, I saw what you call a portal in the realm of the spirit. And I exclaim, oh, so this is what they call a portal. That was why I made this figure for myself. You see a man standing here, is looking at an open heaven. Bible says, and the heaven opened, and I saw the Son of God standing at the right hand of man. And Jesus was baptized in the water, and the heavens opened, and the Spirit of God came upon him like a dove. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day. So you see, this is a portal, it's a gateway. Actually, it's also for me a way of escape. When I stand before this in meditation, I enter into so many things. So I don't want to get to many other details other than to say this is what this represents. Let's continue this drawing. Sorry, I'm a bit getting a bit sweaty. Now, so you look at the wall in your house. Look at your marriage picture, or maybe the picture of your children. What does it say to you? Every time you come back, you will remember the emotions, the joy, the gladness. You look at your children's picture. Maybe what you have on the wall now, the children even have grown older than that. They no longer look like what you put on the picture. It doesn't matter. You will remember when they were small. You remember what they look like now. And you see, so many things are into having something on your wall. Now, don't think having a picture on your wall is not doing anything. Okay, let us assume I remove these two pictures you are seeing at the back right now, and I put this side. Just for example, the picture of a naked woman, and I put this side, the picture of an accidented victim, hands and legs chopped off. What do you think will happen? If you enter that place, the first thing you'll be looking at is those pictures. And it's going to have an impact on you. If you're a very, religious person, you may take offense. Why is he putting a naked woman's picture in? I don't have a naked woman's picture in my hand. I'm just giving you an example. So that means even when the picture you have on the wall is dusty, he's still speaking. Don't leave dust in your house, I'll clean up. But I'm just giving an example. It is still speaking. This one I did here is also part of destiny and journeys, but I cannot go into explanations like this. So the next time you are in your house, go back, woman, sister, brother, look at what you have on your wall, and you will see that you have messages that are talking to you there that you have not enjoyed much more. In my thoughts, in my meditations, I walk around, whether in my house or in my office. In fact, some of these portraits, before I sell them, I make sure I enjoy them first. I enjoy my art before I sell it out. If you are interested in any of these things I'm saying, you can get in touch with me. I am not doing this video just for advertising to sell. I'm doing this video to just sensitize you to the fact that your walls are speaking. Are you enjoying what you have on your walls? So put pictures of your victory, put relevant pictures of your testimony. Let me show you one more picture before. I think I took this picture in Cotonou. Yeah, this is a picture that I titled Cloud of Witnesses. Why? Also based on the divine experience I experienced. Some different things I experienced. There was a day I just sat down and I was thinking about ancient and modern saints, people who have worked with God according to Bible that I know. And as I was mentioning their names, honoring them, I suddenly looked up, the heavens opened, and I saw people gathered looking down towards me. So this is a representation of that. Now let me show you maybe one more, then we can go. I use this I took these people, I think, I said, I do our evil things. Yeah. I use this to represent life as a game of, as a game. Life is a game of strategy. It's a game where you have an opposing force that you have to defeat. And this picture, whenever I look at it, what is the right move? You see all those holds, it's called Ayo in Yoruba language. This game is called Okwayo. But I think on your computer, you may see it called Awali. So, Okwayo is in Yoruba language. Sorry, I've got a noise right here, and somebody's walking at the back here. So you see, life's about moves, strategies. And that's where you see, they take the seeds, put them in the relevant holes, and that determines who wins. So I use this as a strategy of life. There are other things I may show you, but just that I think by now you've got the idea. So I would like to stop this video at this point. You need to go back and look at your walls. And if you don't, if you have your walls empty, get in touch with a photographer or whatever. Even if it's your graduation picture, put it up on the wall. It's your house, it's your wall. Enjoy what you see there. Remember your victories. And while you are in, and if you're in any trouble, put things that will inspire you, that will encourage you. Look, every time I come back to any of these my pictures or frames, or sometimes maybe I had sold it, but if you get to that person's house, you look at it in the wall and in their office, I still see new things. A good picture always delivers. Picture is all about stories. So next time you look at your wall, remember, there is experiences there, there are stories there, there are values that you can add to your life. You can just look at a picture and just smile. Maybe it's your child that, who is now maybe about 25 years old, and at then it was just 2 years. You have it on your wall framed up there. You look at it and you're like, this boy has grown old. You remember the happy experience and every other thing. So this is what it's all about. I hope you find this video enjoyable, how to enjoy your pictures, how to view your pictures, and to, you know, whatever it is. This is the first part of this video. There's another part I will come up with, which will be titled Never Leave Your Walls Empty, and I will go into fuller details of some things I couldn't share now. So friends, till next time, before I bring you another video, have a nice day, have a nice month, enjoy yourself and enjoy your world. Peace.